Welcome. Previously, we have discussed some power quality issues like transients, long duration voltage variation, short duration voltage variation. And in today's lecture, we are going to discuss the remaining power quality issues such as voltage unbalance, waveform distortion, voltage fluctuation, and power frequency variation. Let's discuss one by one in detail. Voltage unbalance. Voltage unbalance is applicable to three-phase system because you see the word unbalance means we are going to compare two components so that we can say whether it is balanced or unbalanced. So in the electrical system, we are having single phase and three phase. Therefore, in order to compare, this term is applicable only to three-phase system. Okay. So it is not applicable to single phase system. So the definition is that variation in the amplitudes of three phase voltage relative to one another. So in this picture, you see there are three phases. One is phase one, phase two, phase three. And you see the magnitude of all the phases are same. Okay. And the phase difference is also same. That is 120 degree. Therefore, this system, this is called as balanced phases. Okay, and the second picture you can see the red phase. Okay, the phase one, the amplitude of the phase one is different from phase two and phase three. Okay, and if you measure in terms of a degree, it will be 140 degree. Okay, therefore there is a variation in phase. Such system is said to be unbalanced system. Okay. It can also be defined as the deviation of each phase from the average voltage of all the three phases. Okay, this is the definition. The causes of voltage unbalance. Okay, we know that there are three phases, and if one phase is heavily loaded, that means the distribution of loads is not equal. If the distribution of phase is not equal, then it leads to voltage unbalance. Okay, so practically it is very difficult to balance the three phase system. Okay, so there will be an unbalance in the system, in the three phase system, because definitely if you use single phase, one of the phase will be loaded and it is very difficult to balance the system. So this is the basic cause for the voltage unbalance and the effects. So it leads to network problems such as a failure in the relays, then it may affect the voltage regulation equipment, and also when it comes to motoring loads, it may lead to heating losses. Okay, so particularly it affects the three-phase system, three-phase loads. Okay, and in order to avoid the effects of voltage unbalance, it is recommended to use the voltage regulators. The voltage unbalance can be estimated by using this formula. Okay, so first we have to find the average voltage, and then we have to calculate the maximum deviation from the average voltage, and its ratio gives the voltage unbalance. Okay, let us assume the magnitude of three phase voltage be 226 volt, 232 volt, and 235 volt. Okay, so first step is to find the average voltage. So if we sum all the three voltages and if you divide by three, it gives the average voltage. So the average voltage is 231. Okay, and now we have to calculate the maximum deviation. Okay, first let's calculate the deviation for each voltage. Okay, so the deviation we can calculate for 226. The deviation between 226 and 231 is 5. Okay, and the deviation between 232 and 231 is what? 1. Okay, and the deviation between 235 and 231 is 4. So we are having the deviations like 1, 4, and 5. So the maximum deviation is, this is the maximum deviation. Okay, so once we calculate the maximum deviation, then we can apply the formula, that is maximum deviation from average voltage is 5 and the average voltage is 231. So the voltage unbalance is 2.16%. Okay, so the permissible limit will be 0.5% to 2.5%. So this lies within this limit, therefore it won't affect much. Okay, so this is how we have to calculate the voltage unbalance. Waveform distortion. Any unwanted changes in the sine wave, we can call it as waveform distortion. Okay, so it is defined as the steady state deviation from the ideal sine wave is called waveform distortion. There are five types of waveform distortion. One is DC offset, harmonics, interharmonics, notching, and noise. Let's see one by one. DC offset. So we are dealing with the sinusoidal wave, which is AC. So if the DC voltage or DC current is present in the AC system, then it is called as DC offset. Okay. The main causes for this DC offset is the power converters, the asymmetrical nature of the power electronic devices. And the effects of this DC offset is the heating of the coil, as well as it reduces the lifespan of the components or the devices. Okay, and this is the waveform showing the effects of DC offset, and this is the ideal sine wave, and this is the presence of DC offset. You can see the magnitude. Okay, it is decreasing, and in this you can see the effect of DC offset in such a way. The magnitude you see rises from 311 to 342. So there is a presence of 31 volt as DC offset. Okay, so because of this, it may lead to heat and it may spoil the components. Harmonics and interharmonics. Harmonics is defined as the voltage or current that has the frequency which are the integral multiples of fundamental frequency. Okay, for example, if the fundamental frequency is 30 hertz, then what is this integral multiple? So next is 60 and next is 90, 120. In such a way, we will be calculating. So the harmonics is the integral multiples of the fundamental frequency. So the sources for this is the nonlinear devices like computers, variable frequency drives. Okay, that uses the power electronic components like SCR, IGBT, MOSFET, and then UPS, unified power supply. That also uses SCR, IGBT, MOSFET, such devices, such components. Okay, and then interharmonics. So it is like vice versa. Okay, that those are not captured under harmonics are called interharmonics. Okay, so it is defined as the current or voltage whose frequency is not the integral multiples of the fundamental frequency. That comes under interharmonics. Okay, the sources for this interharmonics may be static frequency cycloconverter, power line carrier signal. So those causes the interharmonics. Let's discuss the harmonics diagrammatically. Okay. This is the red line indicates the fundamental frequency. Okay, what is a cycle? The positive half cycle and negative half cycle together is called as a complete cycle. So you see the red line, you see this is positive half cycle and this is negative half cycle. Together we can call it as one complete cycle. Okay, so therefore it is called as fundamental frequency. Okay, so next one is the white line. The white line indicates the third harmonic. Third harmonics means it should have three cycles. You can see here, this is one cycle, second cycle, and this is third cycle. So that we call it as third harmonic. And the blue color indicates the fifth harmonics. That means it should have five cycles. This is first cycle, second cycle, third cycle, fourth cycle, and fifth cycle. Therefore it is called as fifth harmonic. And the pink color indicates the seventh harmonic. Okay, So that means 7 cycles should be there. Okay, this is cycle 1, cycle 2, cycle 3, and this is 4th cycle, 5th cycle, 6th cycle, and this is 7th cycle. Okay, therefore it is called as 7th harmonic. And the yellow color line indicates the resultant harmonics. Resultant harmonics means if we take the average, then it will be like that. Okay, you see the yellow color line is different from the fundamental frequency. Okay, it deviates from the ideal sine wave. Therefore, you can say there is an existence of harmonics, and this harmonics comes under waveform distortion. Okay, all right. And the next, we can discuss about the table. And in the table, you can see the first harmonic is 50 hertz. That means the waveform is a 50 hertz waveform. Okay, so the multiples of 50 is what? The second harmonic will be 100, third harmonic will be 150, fourth harmonic will be 200. Anything in between this, we can call it as interharmonic. You see here 175 is in between 150 and 200. Therefore, it is called as interharmonics. And the first harmonic frequency is 50. Anything less than 50 is also called as subharmonic or interharmonics. Okay. All right. Harmonic indices. So the harmonics can be measured with the help of this harmonic indices. There are two types of harmonic indicators. One is THD and another one is TDD. So THD is called as total harmonic distortion. Okay, which is defined as the ratio between RMS value of the harmonics to the RMS value of the fundamental. Okay, so in the previous slide we have discussed about the fundamental frequency and the resultant harmonic, So if you divide, or if you find the ratio between the fundamental and the resultant harmonics, then it gives the total harmonic distortion. And this is the formula to calculate the total harmonic distortion. So we can calculate the total harmonic distortion for the voltage as well as total harmonic distortion for the current. And you can see in the denominator, this is the fundamental voltage and this is the fundamental current. Whereas in the numerator, you can see the integral multiples. That means starting from the next integral multiple. Okay. So for example, if the fundamental frequency is 50, then what is the voltage magnitude at the 50 will be placed here. Okay. And in the numerator, we will be starting from 100 hertz. Okay. So the second integral multiple, the magnitude of voltage at the second integral multiple, that is at 100 frequency, and the magnitude of voltage at 150 frequency. Likewise, we will be squaring the voltage and then we will be finding the resultant value. And using this calculation, you can find the value of total harmonic distortion for the voltage. And similarly, it is applicable for the current. Okay, total demand distortion. So in total demand distortion, we will be considering the load currents. Okay, previously in total harmonic distortion, we have not considered this load current. We will be using the fundamental harmonic and then the integral multiples of the fundamental frequency. Whereas in the total demand distortion, we will be using the load currents, okay? Because it depends on the maximum power consumed by the consumer, okay? How will you determine the maximum power consumed by the consumer? If the current is more, then that means the consumers are consuming more power. Whereas if the current is less, that means the consumers are consuming less power. So this factor is taken into consideration and it is given, and the name is given as total demand distortion. Okay. And the others are same. You can see here, you see the second harmonic is considered, third harmonic, fourth harmonic. So it is considered in the calculation. Okay, so except the denominator, because we have to consider the maximum demand. And with the total demand distortion, we can calculate the current, and we cannot calculate the voltage, because the voltage is same. Even though if the demand is more, if the consumers consume more power, the voltage remains same. And similarly, if the consumers consume less power, the voltage will be same. So the total demand distortion is applicable only for calculating the current harmonics. Okay. Notching. So if the voltage disturbance is periodic, that is, you can see the notches at particular interval of time. Okay, you see the interval is same, that is periodic. Okay, so if it exists like this, then this type of disturbance is called as notching. Okay, and this is normally occurs due to commutation from one phase to another phase. Noise. All other unwanted electrical signal which causes the disturbance to sine wave is called noise. Okay, the sine wave distortion other than DC offset, harmonics, interharmonics, notching is called as noise. Okay, and this may be caused due to power electronic devices and some types of arcing equipment, and its effect will definitely affect the sensitive equipments like microcomputer and some programmable devices which use power electronic components. Okay, voltage fluctuation or flicker. And we know that the allowable limit for the voltage is in between 0.9 to 1.1 per unit. Okay, so let us consider this as 1.1 per unit, and this line as 0.9 per unit. And if there is any sudden change between these two limits, okay, within these allowable limits, so this sudden change within this allowable limit is called as voltage fluctuation. Okay, and this rapid change we can see on certain lamps, okay, with the help of our human eye. And if you see with the help of human eye, then we will be calling it as flicker. Okay, so that is the undesirable result of fluctuation. It won't cause it won't affect the component, but since it is visible in our human eye, we are going to say as flicker. Okay, since these two terms are linked together, it is commonly called as voltage flicker. Okay, power frequency variation. As the name indicates, any variation in the frequency is called as power frequency variation. For example, if the system is a 50 hertz system, and let's have a tolerance of 2 hertz, that means 52 hertz or 48 hertz. Anything above 52 hertz and anything below 48 hertz is considered as the power frequency variation. And if the variation is more, then it is going to affect the whole system, okay, both the transmission as well as distribution system, and the effect will be very worst. And with the modern technologies and in the day-to-day life, these frequency variations are very rare. Okay, so that's all about the power quality issues. Thank you.